American composer William Grant Still qualifies as the quintessential American success story. The grandson of a former slave on a Georgia plantation, William Grant Still first studied the violin, cello, and oboe in the early 1900s before he embarked on a course in composition at the Oberlin Conservatory, subsequently undertaking work as a commercial arranger. Often referred to as the Dean of African American Composers, Still rose from humble beginnings to become the first African American to have his compositions performed by professional orchestras. Please join me in welcoming conductor Eric McAllister and the Philharmonic Strings. Philharmonic Strings. The brilliant Polish violinist Henri Wieniawaki, a violinist of genius in the mold of Paganini, possessed astonishing technical prowess and an intensity of expression that moved his listeners to tears. A prodigy, admitted to the Paris Conservatory at the age of 8. He graduated with first prize in violin at the age of 10. During his teens, he concertized in Europe and Russia, often with younger brother Joseph at the piano. He wrote this piece for violin piano when he was 13 years old. It was later republished as Polonaise Brillante for full orchestra, accompaniment in 1958. We have another of our special guests this evening, a concert violinist from New York who performs around the world. Would you please help me welcome Yen-Ling and the Philharmonic. Well, written in 1990 by one of the founders of Venezuela's Onda Nueva style, it's picked up on Brazilian bossa nova and the Venezuelan Europa. Composer pianist Aldemaro Romero is known for his ability to mix popular songs and folk elements with classical forms and techniques. The Fuga con Pajarillo, which is a movement from his suite number 1 for strings, does just that. And it was the piece that Gustavo Dudamel brought to the Gustav Mahler conducting competition that he won in 2004. The Pajarillo, pervading the melody and rhythm, gives a sense of improvisation and contrasts with the predetermined fugal form. And that's just one of the things that makes this a very fascinating piece. As the techs get their finishing touches in. We want to make sure this is all captured and that you hear the sound as it was intended. Special guest artist, Mariachi International!
Thank you.
fabulous Smith Center tent crew. Composed in 1889, Symphony No. 8 features music that is cheerful and optimistic. Tonight we'll hear the fourth movement of the Dvorak piece, Allegro Non Troppo, the most turbulent movement, but it progresses to a beautiful melody. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome conductor Jeremy Paredes, and once again, the outstanding Las Vegas Academy, Philharmonic.
Thank you.
little bit closer to our time. This was composed in response to the tragic attacks of September 11th, 2001. Rene Clausen's memorial premiered in New York City at the 2003 American Choral Directors Association National Conference. Scored for choir and orchestra, Clausen's memorial musically depicts the emotional journey that we all took that historic day. The final movement, which you'll hear tonight, pleads for mercy and peace. And we have another special guest to talk about that. He served in New York City on 9/11. Please welcome Officer Ed.
First, I'd like to thank everyone at LVA for inviting me to be here. It is a great honor. The piece you're about to hear was composed for the 2003 ACDA conference that was held in New York City after the tragic events of September 11th, 2001. I was asked by Mrs. Franken to be here because of my connection to New York and the events on 9/11. As mentioned by Mr. Tannenbaum, I'm currently a captain with the Henderson Police Department. However, on 9/11, I was a police officer with the New York City Police Department and a member of the Emergency Services Union. Like hundreds of other first responders, I responded to the World Trade Center. I was fortunate enough to survive the events that unfolded that day. However, many were not. Over 400 first responders and 2,500 civilians perished. 14 members of my own unit were lost that day. Like many New Yorkers, I lost neighbors, co-workers, and friends. This piece was composed to honor all the lives lost on September 11th. Please join me in remembrance of those lost by enjoying Kyrie from Memorial by Rene Clausen. Thank you.
performance is the final performance of this evening. And before we get there, we want to take a moment to simply say thank you. And to note that the incredible and world-class guest artists from this evening were funded completely by the Master Artist Series, sponsored by the Friends of the Las Vegas Academy, and you know who you are! We thank you for your generosity, and further contributions are always welcome. Commissioned as the finale of the 2015 American Choral Directors Association High School Honor Choir Concert, this gospel selection features energetic vocals supported by an exciting orchestral score. Featured tonight, soloist Tymara Walker. Living legend Gladys Knight has toured the world as a background singer for the iconic Chaka Khan, was part of Cirque du Soleil's Michael Jackson show on the Las Vegas Strip, and so much more. I think you're in for a treat as Ms. Walker joins the Las Vegas Academy Symphonic Chorus, the Philharmonic, and conductor Matt Ostley to once again close out tonight's concert with Gloria!
It's a little unorthodox, but if you believe that God deserves glory, can you put your hands together?
Glory! Glory to God!
school night. Good night.